All right, so we already know the placement of integers on the number line. So we can think of adding as going in the direction of the number that we're adding, and subtraction as moving in the opposite direction of the number that we are subtracting. We already know negative numbers are to the left of zero, positive numbers are to the right of zero. So let's do some visualization. Let me say I want to think about negative of negative 3. So negative 3 can be thought of as a debt. If I took away your debt, then you're $3 richer, right? So basically, negative on the negative 3 makes it additive inverse of negative 3, which is 3. So here we have a debt of 3. Somebody took it away, which made you $3 richer. All right, let's think of negative 6 minus 3. Suppose you already had $6 charge on your credit card, and now you just bought a coffee for $3. What is the balance on your credit card? So we have $6 debt and then additional $3 debt. So now we are $9 in debt. So you can think of subtraction of 3 as going in the opposite direction of 3, because 3 is that way. Negative. So subtracting a 3 means going in the opposite direction. Subtracting a negative 25. So you owe $100 on your credit card. You return a $25 pair of jeans. So that means the negative $25 you owed was removed from that $100 credit card balance. So now what? So let's take a look. $100 debt. We had $25 debt removed. So you're going negative, so that's a subtraction. Subtraction of negative 25, move opposite direction to negative 25. Negative 25 is in that direction, opposite will be that direction. So you're going 25 that way, which would be negative 75. All right, let's do some simpler examples. So 2.5 minus 4, so your starting point is 2.5. So let's go to 2.5, okay? Now, subtract 4. Subtract means going the opposite direction of 4. 4 is this way, so opposite direction will be that way. So 4 that way. So that would be negative 1.5. It's important to have this visual sense so that when you're doing problems, if you can just see it in your head, visualize it, it will make things easier. All right, let's do that one on your own. Draw a number line and see what direction you're moving. Pause the video and do it. So we're starting with negative 2. Add 3. So go in the same direction as 3. So that would be this way. 3 that way would be right there. So that'll be 1. All right, negative 2 minus 3.5. So negative 2 would be right there. Okay, subtracting negative 3.5. So going in the opposite direction of negative 3.5. Negative 3.5 is going that way. Opposite direction would be going that way, 3.5. So your answer would be 1.5. Okay, be very careful attention to this, because that will visualizing will help you do it in your head. All right, let's talk about additive inverses. So here's my 2, and additive inverse of negative 2 will bring me to 0. Okay? So if I'm at negative 2, then additive inverse would be plus 2, because that's what brings me to 0. So 2 and negative 2 are additive inverses of each other. This is just a visualization. Try these. Let's talk about absolute value. Absolute value of a real number is defined to be the distance one travels on a number line to go from 0 to the number x. And it's denoted by these two vertical bars and an x sitting in between them. For all non-zero real numbers x, this distance is always considered to be a positive number. So for example, absolute value of 3 is 3. Absolute value of negative 3 is 3, and absolute value of 0 is 0. If I told you that I want to look at all numbers for whom absolute value is 5, then there's only two places on the number line, 5 and negative 5. are the only two places for whom distance from 0 is 5 units, right? So from geometric view of addition, it should be clear we can always get back to 0 on the number line by starting with any movement from 0 and then going the same distance but in the opposite direction. So that algebraically translates into saying x plus opposite of x equals 0. Well, you might wonder how we can subtract or add complex numbers. We already saw adding complex numbers, you add real parts and imaginary parts. What about subtraction? Well, same thing. Subtract the real parts and subtract the imaginary parts. But how can we visualize that? So remember how we visualized complex numbers in a plane? So the number 2 plus I go 2 units on the real axis, 1 unit on the imaginary axis. So there's 2 plus I. 1 unit on the real and 3 in the imaginary will give you 1 plus 3i. So the addition, 3 plus 4i, look where it is. You're adding the 1 and the 2, it gave me the 3. And you're adding the 1 and the 3, giving me the 4 on the real. The diagonal vector of the parallelogram is giving you the addition vector. So this is consistent with the vector addition, if you're familiar with that. Otherwise, don't worry about it. We just wanted to give you a sense of how addition works. Now for subtraction. If you want, the negative 2 plus 2i is this red vector right here, right? This is my complex number, negative 2 plus 2i. The opposite of that, which would be 2 minus 2i, is the same vector but going in the opposite direction. You see that here? Okay? And then if you complete that parallelogram, adding them together will give you this vector, which is the subtraction. So subtraction works just like that. That's how you can visualize it. Don't worry too much if you don't understand the visualization of complex numbers, but we wanted to show it to you because many of you keep asking how we can do that with complex numbers. There's also a concept of distance in complex numbers, which we call absolute value again, and it's again denoted by two vertical bars and the complex number sits inside, and it's computed as square root a squared plus b squared, where a and b are the real and imaginary parts of the complex number. This is very consistent with our real number definition, because if b is 0, you'll get square root a squared, and square root a squared is going to be a positive number, which is absolute value of a. Do these problems.